to make sure.
Yeah, he hasn't been on that high before, so.
We can do this. Come over here, and you can walk across this table with him. Just heel right across it. And don't do anything different, just heel across. Now the next time, bring your left hand down, but don't use your left hand to make him move on the table. You're just going to bring your left hand down and hold it right here while you walk across, so that he can't avoid it. Or this next time, put your left hand there and step right here and wait. Okay. Until he stops struggling away from you. Just wait. Just like we did when we turned our hips over our shoulders. There we go. And now I don't care what he does, just move on. Now just stand there. Just let go with your left hand and walk off, because we got the front feet up there, right? So you're going to come back around that table and do the same thing. What I don't want you to do is anything with your leash other than hold your hand in. Right? All that flailing he's doing. Right? Now, let go with your left and just give him a stretchy stretch. And now just walk off that way. The next time you come in, don't put your left hand so far down the leash. Just put your left hand on the leash. Right there. Bring your other foot up. Just stand there. See how you put the looseness in it? Like half a step forward onto the table. Stay on the table, but move like a half a step. Now, I would have had you step with your left leg first instead of your right. Right? Turn that way. Casually walk off at an angle. There, we got all 4 feet up. Right? Go back again. It's just not generalized to them. And this makes noise. The cinder blocks don't.
Yeah, that's true.
Just walk. Keep moving. Let go. There we go. Keep moving. Don't put your left hand on it this time. Just walk across it. Just little exercises like this with different objects that he can crawl on, it also is confidence building, right? There we go. The next time you're going to stop on it. Don't do anything with the leash though. He's either going to stop or he's going to continue on across it. I don't care which. And now just walk off. Now the next time, when you get on it, as you're getting on it, bring your left hand over so you can stop him. He doesn't have to sit. But don't do it before he's on the table. Now, oops, you keep moving. So right about here, bring your left hand to your right. But don't move it down, and then as you're stepping up, you can restrict. Alright? Now come down. Don't pull them up. Take like a 45 degree turn.
Which way?
In the opposite direction that you pulled. So and now wait.
So you're going to hold that.
Yep.
Not let him turn around at me. And now walk off. Just cross it again. Don't try to stop. Now come straight at it. Up and over.
So now this time, your hands are involved, but not to move him, to keep him
right.
And stop and sit for a moment.
And what you can do is bring your hands in and stop, right? So my hands aren't moving him,
right?
If he's flailing around, we can wait. And then when he stops, you should be able to feel the slackness in the pressure. Keep your hands here, and you can take a half a step. Right?
Mm-hmm.
But so that he can't flail around that way. And then when he comes up with you, move that leg there and take a half a step. And let's see if we can get him on that way.
Okay. Just like stop and sit right there. Good boy. A little slack in the leash. Half a step forward. Bring your right foot up. Half a step forward. Bring your right foot up. Half a step forward. Turn your upper body away from him. Half a step forward with your left. Half a step forward with your left. Keeping your hands where they are, turn to the left and go over the table. Come right back to it. Step up onto the table with your left. Move your left over a little more so you're on the table more. Step up with your right. Step forward. Forward. Don't be brat. You're not going to step on it, but put your left leg up on that bench. turn the heel off?
Right.
Just walk off.
Let me see. Heel.
I was trying to figure out how to tell you what I just did. So you see how I moved back like that and got around. Sometimes it's hard to figure out while I'm watching. You did all the hard work. See how I didn't drive him?
Yeah.
I just had my hand there and I got you. So when you are coming up to the table, come over this way so that your stepping is here and then here to move up on that. But if you go to step and he's flailing around back this way, just get up on it, and if he's still flailing around, go that way. Next time you come up on it, sit mold him on the table. So you're just going to stop him on the table, and if he doesn't go into it, you're just going to place him into it.
Sit.
Now, next time, do it a legitimate sit mold. Run your left hand down, have your right hand here, and do this. You just push down on the
spot. Yeah, I don't remember. It's been a long
time. Yeah, it's been a while. Right? Just heel off.
So,
as you're coming up on the table, run your left hand down to stop him.
Right.
Then your right hand takes it. Then your left hand goes down, dog, as your right hand comes up.
Okay, so right? It's back behind the ears, that's right.
Right. Because we had such a big effort to get him on there, I don't want to beat him up on the table, right? I just want you to calmly put him in the mold, all right?
Here we go.
And this time, don't do anything other than the way you're holding the leash right there, all the way up on the table.
Still coming across?
Yeah. Now just come up with your right, down with your left. There we go. Scritchy, scritchy. Good boy. Heel him off.
Look him.
The next time you come up, bring your left hand all the way down the chain to him, or right hand, two-handed sit presentation. Give a clear sit, 1001, 1002, and then just calmly correct the fit. Now correct. Good boy. Heel him off.
would heal.
Good boy. And that's where we're going to stop, because even though we were going to do the down on command, that wasn't the lesson he needed today.
Yeah.
All right?
Let's see what I can do about it.